absolute honor and pleasure to talk to none other than Gulshan Grover. Gulshan, welcome to Women Now.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Honestly, you know, I'm very happy that there is a channel called Women Now. Honestly, I mean, like, women have been there, shall be there forever. But now is the time when women have really, really woken up. So Women Now is really apt, really today. And I really like the name. I really like what you are putting out there. So all the very best. Fantastic.
Well, thank you so much. It's the first time someone really vocally said that at the beginning of the interview. Thank you so much for that. Now tell us who...
I am known for saying what I feel like, you know. So I honestly, I mean, like, I said this because I felt that women of today, women now is a force to reckon with, a force that will set things for future as well.
Thank you so much. A big hug for that.
Thank you.
Now let's find out who is Gulshan Grover. There are so many movies that you've acted, and we always have this tendency to identify an actor with the movies that he's in, and we think that's a real person.
That's right.
But who is Gulshan Grover? What's your mission, vision, and your goal?
You know, I like to say this, that Gulshan Grover is a normal, regular guy, normal, regular person who had tremendous ambitions, desires, aspirations, who worked very hard, took risks, believed in God, and conquered. I mean, like, when I started out in India, in Bollywood, you know, prior to that, I was doing my master's in commerce from one of the topmost commerce college in Asia, called Shriram College of Commerce. And, you know, at that time, everybody thought that I would have a great, fantastic career in commerce, and I took the risk of leaving commerce and going to art. As I said, Gulshan Grover is a normal, regular guy, somebody who has ambition, aspirations, desires that don't necessarily match to the position that Gulshan Grover, or the circumstances that Gulshan Grover is in. This happened then when I left commerce and came to art. This happened again when, many years back, I thought that we make such wonderful films in India, we make fantastic films in India, I must expose Hollywood and the West to our cinema. It was the gutsy, courageous, hardworking, God-fearing, praying Gulshan Grover that said, enough. I'm not just going to be an actor in India, live a happy life in Bombay. I am going to come here, try in the West. And I'm talking about a time when they did not know anything about our films. They didn't know about our names, and there was no internet for them to Google or go on IMDb, you know. And I brought hundreds and thousands of VHS in different trips to show our Bollywood Indian films to them. I mean, like, I was at one point asked, rather, you know, like, you know, in at the customs in Los Angeles, that why am I carrying so many VHS? Mm-hmm. Am I a vendor? Am I selling
VHS? That means it was quite a while back.
That's right. I mean, VHS was the only way to show our Indian films to them. So this is what Gulshan Grover is, that someone who doesn't get scared to experiment, and whose strength for a very long time, forever, has been the strength is the love, affection, and blessings of my fans.
Well,
it's
thank you.
Them, you know, like, I know that whatever I do, otherwise, you know, like, it's been, you know, over 3 decades I've been in movies, and year after year, you know, like, with their blessings, more success. Like, right now, today, it's a record of a kind that I have 4 films releasing in 2 months' time. Nobody has 4 films releasing, you know, these days. They have 1 release, 6 months, nothing of theirs, you know. I have 4 films, 1 different from the other, and I would request you to kindly show trailer of these 4 films. Mm-hmm. And one is a film directed by a female director, Oscar nominated director Deepa Mehta. Mm-hmm. And the film is called Biba Boys.
Okay.
Biba Boys, as you know, in Punjabi, every mother says, Mera puttar bahut biba hai.
Okay.
My kaka bahut biba hai. And these Biba boys on the street are fascinated by crime, by mafia, by guns, this, that, and the other.
मेरी दिलचस्पी उस शहर में है जो इंसान में भरा हुआ है।
तुम जरूर जेल पहुंचोगे।
मरने वाला तो मर जाता है, मुसीबत होती है उनकी जो पीछे रह जाते हैं।
जो अब जा चुके उन पलों को बुला ले।
आप मुझ पर भी शक कर सकते हैं।
आज हम कल की महफिल सजा।
उसकी जिंदगी से दूर रहो।
जो अब याद सी बन गई।
To be very honest, I started my career as a villain. The early years of my life, of my acting career, was villain. I created a brand of villain, as you see from my work, that I broke all that and I play all kinds of roles. One of the films that is releasing is called Chehre. It's a comeback film of actress Manisha Koirala, who went through this illness, you know, where she fought cancer and she's, you know, finally back. Manisha Koirala and me in Chehre play lovers. I'm not the bad guy. It's not a one-sided love. We play lovers where, it's a love at first sight. As you will see in the trailer, that we meet, we see each other the first time. But
my question really is, everybody wants to be a hero. Not too many people want to be a villain. And you've had such a successful career in being a villain, mm-hmm. in so many movies. What was it going through your mind? What were you telling yourself? And no. Some advice that you can give to a new generation?
The thing is, I came from a commerce background. I wanted to create a brand, mm-hmm. a popular brand, mm-hmm. That people identify me with. Mm-hmm. And it was an intentional, this thing. I created the villain brand. I created the bad
created
man.
You created a new space for yourself.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And for that, I had to make many sacrifices. I had to...
Tell me about those sacrifices. Because I had to
leave many films in which I was asked to play the hero. And the money they were offering was enormous. I had very little resources to live with. And they were pressing and they were pressurizing and saying, play the hero in this film. I went through a pressure in one film, sort of accepted it, and then I said, no, I've decided I'm going to create a brand, mm-hmm. therefore I'm not going to play it. Here is your money, I apologize. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to do this film. And those people were so angry with me. Mm-hmm. How can anybody be so stupid? Someone newer, younger, that the person is saying...
It's what you wanted to perceive. Now, what is that one thing that people should leave with when they leave Fog? What is that one message that you have for everyone who attends Fog?
Well, Fog is coming together of various cultures, various ethnicities, various cinemas from different countries. They are coming together of these various different cinemas, films, cultures together. There are going to be Chinese films, there are Filipino films, there are Nepalese films, there's Indian films, there are films from Hollywood. And this is the Fog Film Festival. But the other activity of Fog also brings various cultures together. So Fog, people from Bay Area should be proud of, is coming together of various cultures and spreading the fragrance to each other. The only thing I want to say about women is, for me, woman gave me my first breath, and with her magnanimity and sacrifices, she takes my breath away. I salute you, women. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.